Hello friends, I am Dr. S.V. Patil. In this video, we discuss about the GM counter. Now, initially, we discuss about the introductory part. So, the Geiger counter is an instrument used for measuring the ionizing radiation. It detects ionizing radiation such as alpha particle, beta particles, and gamma rays using the ionization effect produced in a Geiger-Müller tube. It is perhaps one of the world's best known radiation detection instrument. So simply we can say that this Geiger-Müller tube or counter used for detecting and measuring the intensity of radiating particles like alpha particle, beta, gamma particle, etc. And this GM counter or this instrument is one of the world's best known radiation detection instrument. Okay. After that we discuss in briefly. So this is the schematic of Geiger-Müller counter. Okay. Consider a glass tube. Now this is the glass tube. Okay. Or it is also known as a GM tube, along with the electronic circuit. Now this electronic circuit was used to amplify the current. Okay. Now the tube consists of, now this glass tube or GM tube consists of a metal case or metal tube which is enclosed in the glass tube. Understood? Or we can say that a metal tube placed inside the glass tube, and this metal tube acts as a cathode. Okay. Now after that, if we see this figure, then it is observed that a fine metal wire which is passing through the center of the tube acts as a anode. Okay. Understood? That means this metal tube which is placed inside the glass tube acts as a cathode, and the fine metal wire which is passing through the center of the tube acts as a anode. Okay. Now after that, the tube is evacuated. Now this is the tube, and that tube is evacuated and filled with the mixture of argon gas and ethyl alcohol vapor. Okay. The mixture contains 90% of argon at 10 centimeter pressure and 10% of ethyl alcohol at 1 centimeter pressure. Okay. Now again, if we see this figure, then it is observed that one end of the tube here, one end of the tube is enclosed with thin mica sheets which serves as window for radiation. Understood? One end of this tube is enclosed with the thin mica sheets that is used for the radiation purpose. Okay. Or that acts as a window for radiation. Okay. After that, a DC potential difference is applied between the cathode and anode. Or we can say that a potential difference is applied between the metal tube and the wire. Okay, as shown in this figure. Okay. And the voltage is adjusted below the breakdown voltage of the gas. After that, when a high energy particles enters into the tube, it ionizes one or more argon gas atom, and the electrons attracts towards the metal wire or towards the anode, and positive ions attract towards the cathode. Understood? Yes. Now after that, again moving charges ionizes the argon gas, and ethyl alcohol vapor prevents the undesirable valencing. After ionization, current pulse will pass in the circuit and it produces voltage pulse to a voltage value between the 5 and 50 volt. Okay, now this pulse again applied to a counter and number of incoming radiation can be counted. Understood? Now after that, this slide shows characteristics of GM counter. Okay, now from this figure it is clear that below 1000 volt there is a no discharge and hence will show the zero count. Understood? Now between 1000 and 1200 volt the number of pulses are proportional to the voltage in between this region 1000 and 1200 volt. What happened? The number of pulses are proportional to the voltage. Now again above the 1200 volt the number of count remains constant for a certain region or for a certain range. Understood? Above 1200 volt what happened? The number of count remains constant for a certain range of the voltage. Okay, and that is nothing but the plateau region. Plateau. Understood? And again this GM counter can count up to 500 particles per second. Understood? One more time I will discuss this figure. So this is the count rate per minute versus voltage graph is there. Okay, now if you see this figure then it is observed that below 1000 volt there is a no discharge and hence will show the zero count. Between 1000 volt and 1200 volt the number of pulses are proportional to this voltage. Okay, and above 1200 volt the number of counts remains constant for a certain range of voltage and this region is nothing but the plateau region. Okay, now again here this GM counter can count up to 500 particles per second. Okay, now there is drawback also. So the main drawback of GM counter is dead time. Now dead time means the time taken by the tube to recover between counts and it is about 200 microseconds. Okay, again if the radiation density is high the tube will not have time to recover and hence some of the particles may not be counted. So this is the drawbacks of GM counter or GM tube. So one more time I will explain about the GM tube. This is the schematic of GM tube or GM counter. So if we see this figure then it is observed that there is a glass tube or it is also known as a GM tube. And this GM tube connected or along with the electronic circuit. And this electronic circuit is used to amplify the current. Okay. Now inside this glass tube, there is another metal tube which acts as a cathode. Again, a metal wire or fine wire which is passing through the center of the tube acts as a anode. Okay, now this tube contains mixture of argon and ethyl alcohol vapor. Okay, and that mixture contains 90% of argon at 10 centimeter pressure and 10% ethyl alcohol vapor at 1 centimeter pressure. One more thing is there, one end of this tube enclosed by a thin mica sheets which acts as a window for radiation. Okay, so this is about the construction of the GM tube. Okay, now after that, here DC potential difference is applied between the anode and cathode. Now this is the anode and this is the cathode, and between these two, anode and cathode, we apply the DC potential. Okay, and the voltage is adjusted below the breakdown voltage of the gas. After that, when high energy particles enters into the tube, it ionizes one or more argon gas atom. So after that, the electrons attract towards the anode and positive ions attract towards the cathode. Okay, after ionization, current pulse will pass in the circuit, okay, and it produces voltage pulse. So an electronic pulse amplifier amplifies this voltage pulse to a voltage value between the 5 to 50 volt. This pulse again applied to a counter and number of incoming radiations can be counted. Now this slide shows characteristics of GM counter. Now along y-axis there is a rate of count and along x-axis there is a applied voltage. Okay. Now if you see this figure, then it is observed that below 1000 volt there is a no discharge and hence it will show a zero count. Okay. In between 1000 and 1200 volt, the number of pulses are proportional to the voltage. Above 1200 volt, the number of count remains constant for a certain range of the voltage, and that region is nothing but the plateau region. Okay, so this GM counter can count up to 500 particles per second. Now this GM tube have some drawbacks. So the main drawbacks of this GM tube is dead time. Now dead time is the time taken by the tube to recover between the counts, and it is about 200 microseconds. If the radiation density is high, the tube will not have time to recover and hence some of the particles may not be counted. So these are some drawbacks of the GM counter. Thank you.